Hello students, today we'll learn about the new chapter, that is torsion. In torsion, we'll learn about the design of shaft based on the rigidity criteria. So design of shaft on the basis of rigidity is divided into two parts, that is according to the torsional rigidity and according to the lateral rigidity. For a shaft subjected to twisting movement, the angle of twist is given by theta is equal to TL upon GJ, which should be less than or equal to theta. Now, in the theory of pure torsion or torsional equation, we have learned that T by J is equal to g theta by L. So from this, what I can do is I can interchange the position of all the values. So this becomes TL upon GJ should be equal to theta. So this is according to the torsional rigidity, where T is the torque applied, L is the length of the shaft, J is the polar moment of inertia of the shaft about the axis of rotation, G is the modulus of rigidity of the shaft material. Therefore, for the known values of T, L and G, that is torque, length and the modulus of rigidity, and allowable value of angle of twist, that is theta, the diameter of the shaft can be calculated. Next is lateral rigidity. Bending moment acting on any shaft is given by M is equal to EI d square y upon dx square. Integrating this equation twice with respect to x and applying the boundary conditions, y can be calculated, and this y is termed as deflection. So when you integrate this, once this becomes M is equal to EI dy by dx, which is the value for slope, and again if you integrate, this becomes EI y, and this y is known as deflection. Y should be less than or equal to allowable value of deflection, which is expressed in mm. Thank you.